joined by William Micklem, somebody who you've met before on RT Racing. He is a master of all horse matters, and he's brought along a skull, a horse's skull. William, what's it all about? It's a complex piece of bone structure.
It is, but when you see from the inside like this, you can tell that the horse's skull is shaped in a particular way so that the upper jaw is wider than the lower jaw. This means that, when you put this back together, that you can see how the upper jaw protrudes over the lower jaw, which means that so many horses are uncomfortable. And if you want a horse to perform well, you want to make it comfortable on a daily basis. If it's comfortable, it's going to do a better job here on the race course or in a show jumping ring or an eventing.
This is what you have designed, and it's now the world's best-selling bridle.
This is the answer. This is the Micklem bridle, which is produced by Horsewear Ireland in Dundalk. And you can see where it fits here is that there's no pressure on the upper jaw teeth whatsoever. And just as important, here where I put my pen, there actually are some nerves coming out of there, the infraorbital nerve. And my bridle puts no pressure on the infraorbital nerve. Now, because of the type of nosebands which are used, it actually puts pressure on the nerve and numbs the very area where the bit is, which is not good for performance and is not comfortable. It also has a shaped headpiece which avoids any pressure on the top of the head. So overall, you're talking about simplicity and comfort. The horse is going to run better. Nick Henderson in England had a horse, When You're Ready, Freddy, which won a couple of chases last year, and increasingly it's getting into the racing world. Where it's particularly useful, though, is on a day-to-day basis when you ride the horses, because if they're more comfortable, they're happier, they work better.
We see grackle nosebands, cross nosebands, which, are they severe? I mean, this is so unlike it. But
it's a question of a good idea has to give way to a better idea. So, yes, the crisscross nosebands put pressure on the teeth here and pressure on the nerve, and that's not good. This doesn't put any pressure on the teeth. It puts no pressure on those nerves.
William, it's great to see you here. Now, in 10 days' time, you're going to be speaking to an international conference of eventing people, and you're going to be telling them that the thoroughbred has a big part to play in their sport.
Yes, in a very nice way, I hope. I'm going to be reminding them that the thoroughbred is the supreme athlete and the great breed improver. We all know that the thoroughbred is the fastest horse in the world, but what most people don't realise, it's also the supreme jumping horse. No horse has ever jumped over 8 foot apart from thoroughbred horses. The world record is actually at 8'2", but a number of thoroughbred horses have jumped over 8 foot. No horse in the world can regularly jump over 30 foot apart from a racehorse, apart from a thoroughbred. They are the supreme athlete, and also so important. As you probably know, they're a major part of the traditional Irish horse, and the traditional Irish horse is famous for its forwardness.
Is it a changing landscape? I mean, are we talking about a discipline now? Why is the thoroughbred becoming more and more useful in eventing?
People forgot about it. There's been a whole period of time where the warm blood has taken over. The Continental have marketed the warm blood, and we've forgotten that the thoroughbred is a very important ingredient. And so I want to remind people how useful the thoroughbred horse may be, and particularly because it's forward thinking. And to have the right attitude is so important.
Tell me about mares, because mares are becoming more prevalent in eventing. Why should they? And you're a fan, aren't you?
I'm a real fan of mares. Actually, the theme of the conference is horsemanship. And Robbie Power, as you know, from the jockey's world, is coming over to talk about horsemanship as well. If we ride horses and train horses in a more humane, in a better way, mares are happy. Now, it wasn't such a long time ago you wouldn't get any mares in show jumping and in dressage. Now, mares are, you know, there are a lot of mares in show jumping. We don't worry about mares in show jumping. And increasingly, there are more mares in dressage because people are training in a more humane and a softer way. And as regards the racing, you train the mares well, you have good horsemanship, you don't just treat them as machines, then the mares perform for you. And I think Willie Mullins is a master at getting those mares to perform by treating them as individuals, not treating them as machines. And the bridle and everything they do is about trying to relate to the horse as a horse and not a machine.
You are a master of innovation. Now, something that you haven't brought along, because it's a year of production, I understand, in racing terms anyway, is a girth that will hopefully stop the saddle from slipping. That would be huge in racing.
Well, it's going to be a game changer, and it's exactly the same as the bridle. It's designed from the inside out to fit the the rib cage itself, because when you look closely at the rib cage, you realize that these girths do not conform to the shape of the rib cage, which is why that there's always a struggle. There's always something wants to pull here, something wants to pull there. So the Micklem girth, again produced by Horsewear, it's going to be a game changer. I'm very excited by it.
Now, I tell you what, it's 15 years since you produced this book. This is the complete horse riding manual, and it is a bit of a Bible, I have to say. Anything coming up?
I'm in the process of doing a new book at the moment. Its basic working title is Simplicity, and I think the racing world is a great example of keeping things simple and practical. In the sport horse world, in the general world, I want to see tens of thousands more people riding. They will do this if we can make it easier for them to ride. We make things too complicated. So the book is about simplicity.
Thank you for joining us so much. Thank you.